So we back at it again today, and today we're going to be doing this topic here, which deals with the logic and the investigation question, which is about sequences. So we're dealing with a question that deals with sequences, which is question 8 in the CXE paper. And a sequence is like a group of numbers that follows a particular pattern. Now, this topic is brief. So I just do a brief tutorial video showing you how it is that we work our way around this particular question. Now let's say a question is given. So we have a table where it is that we have the figure. And let's say they give us our next column here, which is the number of dots. So we have the figure and the number of dots. And the first figure, let's say, has 3 dots. The second figure has 7 dots. The third figure has 11 dots. And the question now would ask us to find out the number of dots for the fourth figure. And then they might skip. They might ask us for the number of dots for the tenth figure. They might ask us to find out for the nth figure as well. Now, how it is that we work this question? Let's just stray from this question a bit. Anytime we have sequences, let's say we have a sequence like this, we have 5, we have 11, we have 17, 23, 29, 35, and so forth. This is going on and on. The first term of this sequence is 5. The second term is 11. The third term is 17. The fourth term is 23. The fifth term is 25, and the sixth term is 35. It's 29. The fifth term is 29, and the sixth term is 35. They can ask us to probably find for the seventh term, the eighth term, the ninth term. But anytime that you want to find out for a specific term in a sequence, where it is that the sequence increases by a fixed amount, we see here that this sequence increases by 6. 5 plus 6 is 11. 11 plus 6 is 17. 17 plus 6 is 23. 23 plus 6 is 29. 29 plus 6 is 35. 35 plus 6 would give us 41. 41 plus 6 would give us 47. And so forth, they just keep adding 6. Anytime that a set of numbers increases by a fixed amount, as in this case, we have a sequence, and this sequence here is governed by a particular equation. Now we can formulate the equation to find out for any term of the sequence. The equation that we use to find for any term in the sequence is a plus n minus 1 times d. And this gives us for whatever term that you want to find in the sequence. T is the term, and N represents what term you want to find. Now, A is your first term in the sequence. N is your unknown term. That is the term that you want to find for. And D is your common difference. D is what the sequence is increasing by. So if it is that, well, in this case, we know the fourth term is 23, the fifth term is 29, the sixth term is 35. Let's say we know that the sixth term is 35. Let's use the formula to figure out what the sixth term is. So pretend that we don't know that the sixth term is 35. Using the formula to find out the sixth term, Tn, that would be T6. N is the term that you want to find for. So if you want to find for the sixth term, you're replacing N with 6. Right, because N represents your unknown term. That is the term that you want to find for. So T6, so the sixth term would be A, which is your first term in the sequence, that is 5. Plus, open brackets, N is the term that you want to find for, which is 6. Minus 1 times D is your common term, that is your common difference. So your common difference here is how much it increases by. It increases by 6 here. And when you simplify this, you get 5 plus 6 minus 1 is 5. By 6. 5 by 6 is 30, and 30 plus 5 you get 35. So you can calculate it, or if it is that some students list out all the terms, and when they list out the terms, they identify that the term that they want. So if they want any 100 term, it will make sense if you want to list out the 100 terms and identify from the sequence, we could calculate for the 100 terms. So let's say they wanted us to find for the 100 term. We're just being curious. Finding for the 100 term, that would be T100, you're replacing them with 100, is equal to open brackets 100 minus 1, close brackets, D is a common difference, which is 6, plus A. Right, so remember, it's A, which is the first term, that would be 5, plus open brackets 100 minus 1 times D, which is your common difference, that is 6. Simplifying this, you get 5 plus 100 minus 1, you get 99 by 6. 99 by 6 is 594. So we get 5 plus 594. We get 599. So the 100 term in the sequence will be 599. So this is how we find for the terms in our sequence. You can use this formula here, where A represents your first term, N is the term that you want to find for, and D is your common term, the common difference. So we use the same principle here. Let's say I want to find out for the fourth term. To find out for the fourth term, you look to see. So we have a sequence here. We have 3, 7, 11, and so forth. This is increasing by 4. 3 plus 4 is 7. 7 plus 4 is 11. So the next term, 11 plus 4, you get 15. Alright, so identifying that term, you get 1 mark for that. If you want to find for the 10th term, there's two ways you can do it. You can list out the numbers 3, 7, 11, 15. You keep adding 4, 19, 23, 27, 31, 35, 39. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the 10th term of that sequence will be 39, or you can have calculated it. If it is that you want to find out for the 10th term, T10, which is your 10th term, will be A plus N minus 1 times D. A is your first term, which is 3. Plus N is your term that you want to find for, which is 10. Minus 1, and D is how much the sequence is increasing by, the fixed number, which is 4. Simplifying this, we get 3 plus 10 minus 1 is 9 by 4. 9 4s are 36. 3 plus 36, we get 39. So you can either calculate it, or we can list out the elements in the sequence and identify what term that they want. If they want the 10th term, list out 10 terms, and the 10th term would be, as in this case, be 39. If they want the 15th term, list out 15 numbers, and the 15th number in the sequence will be whatever that they want, and so forth. So either you list it, or we calculate it. The nth term, so to find out the nth term, to do that, my advice is to write out the formula. So if you want to find out for the nth term, write out the formula A plus N minus 1 times D. And just substitute. When you substitute in here, you replace A and you're replacing D. You're not replacing anything for N, because it's the nth term. You want the expression in terms of N. So we're not replacing anything for N. A is the first term in the sequence, so that is 3. Plus N minus 1. D is a common difference, that is 4. So we replace that term for A, replace that term for D. And then you expand the brackets and simplify. Expanding means you multiply everything inside the bracket by the number in front. So 4 by N is 4N. So we get 3 plus 4N. 4 by minus 1, you get minus 4. And then you simplify this, we get 4N. 3 minus 4. When simplified, we get 4n, 3 minus 4 is minus 1. So the expression we get is 4n minus 1. So this is our formula that we can use to find out for any term in the sequence. Whatever you replace n as, you will get the term in the sequence. So if it is that you replace n with 1, you get 4 by 1, which is 4, 4 minus 1, you get 3. If you replace n with 2, 4 2s are 8, 8 minus 1, you get 7. Replace N with 3, 4 by 3 is 12, 12 minus 1, you get 11. Replace N with 4, with 10, 4 by 10, you get 40, 40 minus 1, you get 39. So that expression that you want is basically an expression that you can use to find for any term in the sequence. And together to use this, A plus N minus 1 times D. And this is the formula that we can use to find for any term in a sequence, and that sequence is a set of numbers where it is that here it increases by a fixed number, as in this case here, or as in this example illustrated on the far left.